Vortex Energy is a global renewable energy platform managed by a subsidiary of the private equity arm of EFG Hermes. Now, it's just completed the sale of its controlling and management stake in the UK solar energy portfolio in a deal worth about £500 million. Joining us now is Karim Moussa. He's the head of asset management and private equity at EFG Hermes. Karim, I mean, run me through what drove that exit and what you're looking to use those proceeds for.
Hi, Yousef. Good morning. Thank you for having me over. Well, let me step back and just tell you the background of Vortex Energy and then go into this deal specifically and on your question on the proceeds. So today is a very exciting day for us. As you rightly mentioned, we've completed the sale of our controlling stake in a 365-megawatt UK solar portfolio to Trinaga for valuing the portfolio at around £500 million. As you may know, Vortex Energy is a platform that we created in 2015 that invests in operating renewable energy assets across Europe. So since 2015, we've raised and invested €1.3 billion in equity and debt, €500 million out of that in equity, in aggregating assets in wind and solar in Portugal, Spain, Belgium, France, and recently the UK. And we've bundled these assets and continuously started exiting them over the past year. So this is our third exit so far after bundling Vortex 1 and 2 and selling them to JP Morgan last year, which is a portfolio of roughly a gigawatt of wind assets in Europe. And that's our third exit today. Now we plan...
And Karim, well done on those exits. I think we've got all the details in terms of the plan, the return on equity, the investment rate of return at 13%. I think the news release speaks for itself. What we really want to understand is what was the demand like for this placing? Who were the buyers? Give us a complexion of the deal. And what are you going to use the proceeds for?
The demand is quite there. You know, you have the whole suite of investors looking at these portfolios, whether they are, you know, the pension funds and the sovereign wealth funds from, you know, the Middle East or the Americas. And you have the oil giants chasing these assets. So we had major demands all the time for our portfolios. You know, there is long-term buyers in this space that, you know, want to hold these assets to maturity. We're investors in the medium term. We build portfolios, we aggregate portfolios and create value, and then sell to investors that take with lower cost of capital and a long period of hold. Now, in terms of
Karim, I mean, at the same time, we understand from your statement as well that you're looking to build a new platform for new investments and potential new fundraising as well. How much are you looking to raise then for Vortex 4?
We're targeting around €500 million in the next few years. We're setting up a new vehicle now that invests in the new era of renewables. As you may see, in the last 10 years, we were all relying on subsidies and incentive plans from the government. Now the renewable energy business have, and specifically solar and wind, have went down significantly in cost. So solar's levelized cost of energy is down by 90% or so over the past 10 years, and wind is by over 50%. So we're moving into an era of a subsidy-free environment. So the new environment now is auctions, corporate PPAs, and a subsidy-free scheme to invest in. We're very excited in this space. We're looking at markets across the globe. And we're also moving down the line in the value chain, investing more in development and in technologies as opposed to buying operating assets like we used to do.
If you look at the geography, Karim, about where the best or perhaps the valuations still offer good value, I'm curious to know, MENA, Africa and Europe, are there valuation differentials in these markets in terms of the assets that you can get your hands on?
Absolutely. I mean, it's all, you know, a risk-return profile equation, actually. So, you know, it's the credit risk of your off-takers that you take into consideration, and you price then basically your power price or PPAs accordingly. So in European markets, if you have, you know, a government or government-linked off-takers in place, you know, as you may know, you know, that, you know, in an interest rate environment so low today as zero or below zero, you know, then the pricing of it will be very, very attractive as opposed to other markets. It's really a risk-return profile. We see a lot of opportunities still in Europe because there's, you know, vast amount of assets and development going on. We see also, you know, very interesting opportunities in Latin America. We're looking at Mexico and Chile. You know, we like Australia. We like America as a whole. So, you know, it's really a global play, and you have to look at where the right risk-return profile and in the right regulatory environment you want to be in.
Karim, thank you so much for being with us. Karim Moussa, well done on the deal, head of asset management and private equity at EFG Hermes.